House and clearing margin. The trade for an outside party must be executed through a broker, and the broker must in turn trade through a member of exchange. Normally, the two parties to a transaction are located far apart and may not even know each other. This becomes an issue of trust and a question of whether the traders will perform as they had promised. To overcome or resolve this uncertainty about performance in accordance with the contract terms, each futures exchange has a clearing house. The clearing house is a well-capitalized financial institution that guarantees contract performance to both parties. As soon as the trade is commuted, the clearing house interposes itself between the buyer and seller. At this point, the original buyer and seller had obligation to the clearing house and no obligation to each other. The exchange clearing house calculates the number of contracts on trading on either a gross or a net basis while calculating clearing margins. The difference between the current spot price on asset and corresponding future prices from the basis. The gross basis simply adds the total of all long positions entered into by clients to the total of all shorts positions entered into by clients. The basis allows this to be offset against each other. For example, suppose that a clearinghouse member has two clients, one with a buy position in 50 countries, the other with a short position in 30 contracts. Gross margining would calculate the clearing margin, the basis of 20 contracts. The whole purpose of the margining system is to reduce the possibility of market participants sustaining losses because of defaults. Hedging in the future market. The future market is so sensitive and organized that a single forward contract can arrange for the precise amount and the maturity that the bank's customer desires. A single future contract is available only in one predetermined amount for one of the four maturity dates each year. These two future of the future markets may force multinational companies to assume some risk of coverage and of currency fluctuation because they usually need specified amount of a currency on a specified date. Still, this risk can be minimized in a properly structured hedge. Prices in the spot and future markets move in the same direction by similar amount due to arbitrage transaction between these two markets. For example, suppose on March 1, an English firm imports 5,000 Swiss watches at a cost of 250,000 euros, with payment and delivery due on April 1. The Swiss firm, being a top negotiator, has demanded that the payment he made in euro upon the delivery of the watches. The exchange rate are $0.6667 per euro in the spot market and the $0.6655 per euro in the futures market for delivery on March 15. Given the cost of marketing the watches, the importer decides that the futures exchange rate is low enough of the company to forecast them and make a profit on the transaction. However, the importer must pay for the watches on March 1, though the expiration date of the future contract is March 15. The importer can hedge most of its exposure by buying March Swiss Euro contract on February 1, with the intention lifting the hedge of March 1 because Euro contracts are available from the IMM in units of 125,000. The importer would forecast 2. March contract. The above explanation can be understood well by the following table. Table 2. Buying 2 Euro future contract on February 1. Spot market future market for March 15. Delivery exchange rate $0.6667 SF, $0.6655 SF, cost of SF 250,166 $675, $166, $375. Action taken and by March 15 contract. The importer could trade out of the contract by selling them before receiving a delivery notice. The importer could buy $250 euros in the future market for $166,375 on March 15. The only risk that the company still faces come from difference in the value of contract on March 1 and its value of March 15. Assume that by March 1, the following two things would happen. Number one, the spot rate appreciate to $0.7658. And number two, the future rate rises to $0.7650. In this situation, let us see what the importer would do. In above situation, the importer could close out the euro future contract by selling them on March 1. This situation can be well understood by the following table. Table 3. Reversing the earlier future contract, future market, spot market for March 15, delivery exchange rate $0.7658 SF, $0.7650 SF. Cost of SF $250,000, $197,450, $191,250. Action taken by SF $250,000, sale March 15, contract on March 1. The importer purchases €250,000 in the spot market for $191,450 and settles its import bill. But this $191,450 is higher than its original value on February 1. In other words, the exchange loss from the spot transaction is $24,775. The future contract the company sold on March 1, $191,250 is higher, $24,875, than the $166,375 the company anticipated in the future contract it forecast on February 1. In one words, the exchange gain form the future transaction is $24,875, the $24,875 gain from the future transaction exceed the $24,775 loss from the spot transaction. The risk that the import assumed on February 1 by purchasing two contracts whose maturity did not coincide with the March 1 usage date currency result in a wide fall exchange gain of $100, $25,875, $24,775. This $100 gain arose from the difference between the spot rate and the future rate prevailing on the day contract were liquidated. This difference is the basis. The basis, unlike the spot rate itself, is relatively stable. It narrows toward zero as the contract moves toward maturity. For example, the basis on February 1 was $0.0012 per franc, $0.6667 to $0.6655. While by March it had shrunk to $0.0008, $0.7658, $0.7650. The degree of uncertainty about the future price diminishes further as the contract approaches its March 15 expiration date. On March 15, the future rate in effect becomes the spot rate. The difference of $0.0004 SF in the basis between February 1 and March 1 account for the windfall exchange gain of $100. This gain might easily have been an exchange loss of a similar amount if the exchange rate of the Swiss franc had depreciated during the same period. The important point is that the importer was protected from any major loss regardless of exchange rate movements. For example, if the importer had not forecast the future contract and bought 250,000 francs in the spot market on March 1, the watches would have cost an additional $24,775. Frequent future trader may try to coordinate trading between two different markets or two different currencies through a strategy called spread trading. Spread trading means buying one contract simultaneously selling another contract. They will always make money on one contract and lose money on the other contract. Thus, they make or lose more money on the one contract than they lose or make on the other, but they are protected from major loss regardless of exchange rate movements. Reference Balov K. International Financial Management Text and Cases, 4th Revised and Enlarged Edition, and MOL. Publication, VVT, LTD, New Delhi, different page. Alan C. Chapiro, Multinational Financial Management, Prentice Hall. Review question. Number 1. What is meant by currency future? Number 2. What is meant by currency forwards? Number 3. Compare and contrast between future and forward markets. 4. Bring the special future of the market. Future market. 5. Bring out the special future of the forward market. Number 6. Explain currency future codes. Number 7. Explain the operation of the future forward markets. 8. What is clearing house and clearing margins? Currency option lesson 2. Lesson outline, introduction, basic terms, market structure, currency option, currency option pricing, currency call option, currency option for home. By reading this lesson, you would be able to understand what is meant by currency option, basic terms for currency option. You will learn about market structure, what are currency option and call option. Who requires currency option introduction? The forward contract provides an exchange rate for the future, but one faces number of circumstances when it may be desirable to have flexibility than a forward provides. For example, a software manufacturer in India may have sale price in US dollar as well as a France franc in Europe. Revenue can be realized in either France franc or dollar, though this depends upon the relative strength of the two currencies. In such situation, the use of forward or future would be inappropriate. That the matter of hedging does not arise because it would be like hedging something which the company does not have. Therefore, what is called for is a foreign exchange option, right, but not the obligation to exchange currency at a predetermined rate. The definition or the basic terms of foreign exchange option is a contract for future delivery of a specified currency in exchange for another, in which the holder of the option has the right to buy or sell the currency at an agreed price. The right to buy is called the right to sell a put. For such a right, the buyer pays a price called the option premium. The option seller receives the premium and he is obliged to make delivery at the agreed upon price if the buyer exercises his option. In sum of option, the instrument being delivered is the currency itself. In other, it is a future contract on the currency. American option permit the holder to exercise at any time before the expiration date. European option only the expiration date. Structure of the market. Options are forecast and traded either on organized exchange such as the Philadelphia Stock Exchange on in the over-counter OTC market. Exchange-traded option of listed option are standardized contract with predetermined exercise prices. Standard maturities 1, 3, 6, 9, and 12 months. and fixed maturity March, June, September, and December. Options not traded in standard contract have the side of IMM future contracts. Cross rate options are also available for the DMY, LDM, and LY. By taking the US dollar out of the equation, cross rate option allow one to hedge directly the currency risk that arise when dealing with non-dollar currencies. The VXLX trade both American style and European style currency option. It also trade month and option, which ensures the availability of a short-term currency option at all times and long-term option, which extend the available expiration months on VXLX dollar based in a close rates contract providing for 18, 24, 30, and 36 months. European style option. On a later date, the PHLX introduced a new option contract called virtual currency option, which is settled in a US dollar rather than in the underlying currency. Other organized option exchanges are located in Amsterdam, European Option Exchange, Chicago, Chicago Mercantile Exchange, and Montreal, Montreal Stock Exchange, OTC. Options are contracts whose specifications are generally negotiated as to the amount, exercise price, and right underlying instrument and expiration. OTC. Currency options are traded by commercial and investment bank in virtually all finance center. OTC activities is concentrated in London and New York, and its certain centers on the major currencies, most often involving US dollar against pound sterling, Deutsche Mark, Swiss franc, Japanese yen, and Canadian dollar. Branches of foreign bank in the major financial center are generally willing at right option against the currency of their home country. The structure of the OTC option market consists of two sectors. Number one, retail market. This market is composed of non-bank customers who purchase from bank what amount to customize insurance against adverse exchange rate movements. And number two, wholesale market. A wholesale market is composed of commercial banks and specialized trading firms. This is mainly involved in interbank OTC trading, trading on the organized exchanges. Most retained customers for OTC option are either corporation active in international trade of financial institution with multi-currency asset portfolios. This customer called V4K's foreign exchange put of calls in organized exchanges, but they generally turn to the banks for option in order to find precisely the term that match their needs. Contracts are generally tailored with regard to amount, strike price, expiration date, and currency. Currency call option. After understanding the structure of the currency option market, both the retail and the wholesale market, it would be useful to understand the currency call option. In the following paragraphs, we would be involved in understanding the currency option available to a buyer. A currency call option is a contract that gives the buyer the right to buy a foreign currency at a specified price during the prescribed period. Firms buy call option because they anticipate that the spot rate or the underlying currency will appreciate. Currency option trading can take place for hedging or speculation. Hedging in the call option market. Multinational companies with open position in foreign currencies can utilize currency call options. For example, suppose that an American firm order industrial equipment from a German company, and its payment is to be made in German marks upon delivery. A German mark call option locks in rate at which US company can purchase marks for dollar. Such an exchange between the two currencies at a specified strike price can take place before the settlement date. Thus, the call option specifies the maximum price which the U.S. company must pay to obtain marks. If the spot rate falls below the strike price, By the delivery date, the importer can buy marks at the prevailing spot rate to pay for its imports and can simply let its call options expire. Speculating in call option market, firm and individuals may speculate with currency call option based on their expectation of exchange rate fluctuation for a particular currency. Purpose of speculation in the call option market is to make a profit from exchange rate movements by deliberately taking an uncovered position. If a speculator expects that the future spot rate of currency will increase, he makes the following transaction. The speculator will, number one, buy call option of the currency, number two, wait for a few months until the spot rate of the currency appreciates high enough, number three, exercise his option by buying the currency at the strike price, and number four, sell the currency at the prevailing spot rate. In order to understand it better, let us have an example. Assume that the call premium for English pound in March 1 is 1.10 cents, the expiration date is July, and the strike price is $1.60. Means anticipates that the set rate of the pound will increase to $1.70 by June 1. If Miss Istotis expects proves correct, what would be her dollar profit from speculation 1 pound call option in the call option market? Miss Istoti could make a profit of $2,781.25 by doing the following trading activities. Number one, buy call option on March 1, $0.0110 per pound. Number two, exercise the option on June 1, $1,600 per pound. Number three, sell the pound on June 1, plus $1,700 per pound. Number four, net profit as of June 1, plus $0.0890 per pound. Number five, net profit per contract, $31,250 times $0.0890 equals $2,781.25. Istuti does not need to exercise her call option in order to make a profit. Currency call option premium rates and fall as exchange rate for their underlying currency rise fall. If call option become profitable, their premiums will rise. They can be sold on an exchange just like any foreign currency itself. Therefore, a call option holder such as Tuti can save the expense and bother of taking possession of the currency and selling it. Currency put option. A currency put option is simply a contract that gives the holder the right to sell a foreign currency at a specified price during a prescribed period. People buy currency put option because they anticipate that the spot rate or the underlying currency will depreciate. Multinational companies who had open position on foreign currencies can employ currency put option to cover such position. For example, assume that an Indian company which has sold an airplane to a Japanese firm has agreed to receive its payment in Japanese yen. The exporter may be concerned about the possibility that the yen will depreciate when it is scheduled to receive its payment from the importer. To protect itself against such a yen depreciation, the exporter could buy yen put option, which would enable it to sell yen at the specified strike price. In fact, the exporter would lock in the minimum exchange rate which it could sell Japanese yen in exchange for US dollar over a specified period of the time. On the other hand, if the yen appreciates over this time period, the exporter could let the put options expire and sell that yen at the prevailing spot rate. Individuals may speculate with currency put option based on their expectation of exchange rate fluctuation for a particular currency. For example, if speculators believe that the German mark will depreciate in the future, they can buy mark puts option, which will entitle them to sell marks at specified strike price. If the mark spot rate depreciates at expected, they can buy mark at the spot rate and exercise their put option by selling this mark at the strike price. Speculators do not need to exercise their put option in order to make profit. They could make a profit from selling put option because put option premiums fall and rise as exchange rate and the underlying currency rise fall. The seller or put option has the obligation to purchase the specified currency at the strike price from the owner who exercises the option. If a speculator anticipate that the currency will appreciate, they might sell their put option. But if the currency ended appreciate over the entire period, the put option will not exercise. On the other hand, if they expect the currency will depreciate, they will keep their put option. Then they will sell their put option when the put option premiums go up. Hedging currency position, various option. Hedging currency has various options such as with foreign currency option. Hedging with currency future contract, let us now explain each one by one. Hedging currency position with foreign currency option. In 1972, the flexible exchange rate system was re-established, and since then, the multinational corporation, international bank, and governments have had to deal with the problem of exchange rate risk. Until the introduction of currency option, exchange rates usually was hedged with foreign currency forward or future contract. Hedging with this instrument allow foreign exchange participant to lock in the local currency values of the revenues of expenses. However, with exchange traded currency option and dealers option, hedgers for the cost of the option can obtain not only protection against adverse exchange rule movements, but benefits if the exchange rate move in favorable direction. This can be understood with the help of an example. Suppose the U.S. Computer Corporation sells. Suppose the U.S. Computers Corporation sells one of its mainframe computers to a German manufacturing company for $625,000 with a payment to be made in Deutschmark by the German company to the U.S. company at the end of 3 months. Suppose the currency exchange rate is $40 DM. Thus, if the U.S. company were paid immediately and the marks were converted in, would receive $250,000. Since payment is not due for 3 months, the U.S. company faces both the risk that the DM dollar exchange rate could decrease, resulting in fewer dollars, and the possible of greater than returns if the dollar DM exchange rate increases. For the cost of DM put option, the U.S. company can protect its dollar revenues from possible exchange rate decreases while still benefiting if the exchange rate increases. With currency future and contracts, with the following option, the foreign currency can be hedged. Number one, by going long in currency call option, the investor can lock in the maximum dollar cost of a future cash outflow or liability denominated in a foreign currency while still maintaining the chance for lower dollar outlays if the exchange rate decreases. In contrast, by going long in a currency put, the investor can lock in the minimum dollar value of a future inflow or asset denominated in foreign currency while still maintaining the possibility of the greater dollar inflows. In this case, the exchange rate increases with foreign currency future and forward contract. The domestic currency value of the future cash flows or the future dollar value of asset liabilities denominated in another currency can he lock in. Unlike option hedging, however, no exchange rate gains exist when future of the forward contract are used. Number two, hedging future currency cash flow with a Navy hedge. Large multinational corporation usually hedge their currency position in the interbank forward market, Various smaller companies, some portfolio manager, and individuals often use the future market. Either way, the currency position usually is hedged with a Navy hedging model in which the number of future forward contract is equal to the value of the foreign currency position to the hedge. The illustrated currency hedging consider that the option hedging example present above, in which U.S. company expected a receipt of 625,000 DM. At the end of 3 months, instead of hedging with a DM put, suppose the company decides to hedge its receipt with a DM future contract expiring at the end of 3 months, currently trading at SF equals 0.40 DM when the spot exchange rate at $0 equals 0.40 DM. Since the contract size on the DM future contract is 125,000 DM, the company would need to go short in 5 DM contract if it uses a Navy hedging approach. 0.40 DM, 625,000 DM, 0.40 DM dollar, 125,000 DM. Doing this, the company would in turn insure itself of $250,000 receipt at expiration when it convert its 625,000 DM to dollar at the spot dollar DM exchange rate closes its short future position. If a multinational has future debt obligation that is required to pay in foreign currency, then it could lock in the dollar cost of the obligation by taking a long future forward position. This hedging strategy, where the dollar cost of forecasting 625,000 DM at the end of 3 months, is hedged with 5 long DM contract price at SF equals 0.40 DM. In this case, the net cost of forecasting the MARIA on the spot and closing future is $250,000 regardless of the spot exchange rate. Currency option of home. Who needs currency option? Currency option are useful for all those who are players or the user of the foreign currency. This is particularly useful for those who want to gain if the exchange rate improves but simultaneously want the protection in the exchange rate deteriorate the most. The holder of an option can lose it the premium he paid for it. Naturally, the option writer faces the mirror image of the holder feature. If you sell an option that the most you can get is the premium if the option dies for lack of exercise. The writer and a call option can face a substantial loss if the option is exercised. He is forced to deliver a currency future contract at the below market price. If he wrote a put option and the put is exercised when he is obliged to buy the currency at the above market price. Foreign exchange option present as asymmetrical risk profile unlike future. Foreign and currency option, this lopsidedness work in favor of the holder and to the disadvantage of the writer. This is why, because the holder pay for it, he takes the risk. When two parties enter into a symmetrical contract, a forward vote can gain or lose equally. Neither party feels obliged to charge the other of the privilege. Forward future swap are mutual obligation. Option are one-sided. The holder of the call has a downside risk limit to the premium paid up front. Beyond that, he gained 1-for-1 as the price of the underlying security. One who has both put option gain 1-for-1 as the price of the underlying instrument fall below the strike price. Trader who had written or sold option face the upside down mirror image profit profile. Those who had bought the same option from the asymmetrical risk profile of option, it's followed that the option are ideally suited to offsetting exchange risk. There are themselves asymmetrical. The risk of a forward rate agreement is symmetrical, hence matching it worth currency option will not a perfect hedge. because doing so would leave you an often or speculative position. Forward contract, future or currency swap are suitable hedges of symmetrical risk. Currency option are suitable in which currency risk is already lopsided, and of those who choose to speculate on the direction and volatility of rates. Options are not only for hedgers, but also for those who wish to take a view. However, for one who says, say, various on the Deutsche Mark, DM put is not necessarily the best choice. One can easily bet on the direction of currency by swing future or forwards. A DM bear would simply, well, DM future limiting his loss. If one to do so via stop loss order. For an investor who has view on direction and on volatility, the option is the right choice. If you think the DM likely to fall below the forward rate and you believe that the market has underestimated the mark's volatility, then buying a put on German mark is the right strategy. Who needs American option? Because if over an additional right, the privilege of exercise on any date up to the expiration date, it gives the buyer greater flexibility and the writer greater risk. American option will therefore tend to be priced slightly higher than European option. Even so, the American option is also always worth more alive than dead, meaning that it pays to sell rather than exercise early. The reason for this statement lies in the fact that most options trade at a price higher than the gain that would be made from exercising the option. Your question number one, what is meant by currency option? Number two, what are the major differences between forward and future contract? Number three, explain the market structure for currency option. Number four, explain currency option pricing. Number five, explain with example the currency call option. Number six, what do you mean by speculating in the call option market? Number 7, examine various aspects of the currency put option. Number 8, explain hedging position with foreign currency option. Number 9, explain with example hedging future currency cash flow with a naive hedge. Number 10, explain who needs option swap. Lesson 3, lesson outline introduction, the concept growth of the swap market, the basic swap structure. After studying this lesson, you would be able to understand the concept, the swap market, the structure of the swap market, growth and functioning of swap market. Introduction, exchange rate, instability and collapse of the Bretton Woods system, and particular the control over the movement of the capital internationally paved the way for the originator of the financial swap market. Today's swap are at the center of the global financial revolution. The growth is such that sometimes it look like unbelievable, but it is true. Though its growth will continue or not is doubtful. Already the shaking has started in the plain vanilla dollar sector, and the profits for broker and markets maker after cost and allocation of risk capital are measured in fewer than 5 basis points. This is before the regulators catch up and form disclosure and capital haircuts. At this spread, the more highly paid must move on to currency swap, tax-driven deals, tailor structure, and shock swap. The fact which is certain is that although the excitement made diamond swap will stay. Already swaps have had a major macroeconomic impact, forging the linkage between the euro and the domestic market, flattening the gas yield curves, and reducing central bank monopoly influence on markets. We are all swappers now, and remember the saying, beware of honey offer on sharp knife when you are offered sweet deals. The problem in the following chaotic process of this very important market is quite simply that he who knows does not speak, he who speak does not know. A glimpse of the growth of swap market and short list of the non-proprietary tools in the swappers arsenal is given below. The concept of the swap. The aim of swap contract is to bind the two counterparties to exchange two different payment streams over time, the payments being tied or at least in part to subsequent and uncertain market price developments. In most swaps so far, the prices concerned have been exchange rate or interest rate, but they increasingly reach out to equity indices and physical commodities. All such prices has risk characteristic in common in quality, if not degree. And for all the allure or swap may be expected cost saving, yield enhancement, or hedging or speculative opportunity. Portfolio management requires financial swap, which are simple in principle, versatile in practice, yet revolutionary. A swap coupled with an existing asset or liability can radically modify effective risk and return. Individually, together with future option and other financial derivatives, they allow yield curve and currency risk and liquidity and geography market consideration all to be managed separately and also independently of underlying cash market stock. The swap market. In the international finance market, most of the new products are executed a physical market, but swap transactions are not. Participants in the swap market are many and varied in their location, character motivates in existing swap. However, in general, the activity of the participant in the swap market have taken on the character of a classical financial market connected and integrating the underlying money, capital, and foreign exchange market. Swap in their current form start in 1981 with a well-publicized currency swap and in the following year with dollar interest rate swap. The initial deal were characterized by the three critical features. 1. Barter. 2. Counterparties with exactly offsetting exposure were introduced by a third party if the credit risk were unequal. The third party, if a bank might interpose itself or arrange for a bank to do so for a small fee. 2. Arbitrage. Driven. The swap was driven by an arbitrage which gave some profit to all three parties. Generally, this was a credit arbitrage or market access arbitrage. 3. Liability. Driven. Almost all swaps were driven by the need to manage a debt issue on both sides. The major dramatic change has been emergence of the large bank as aggressive market maker in dollar interest rate swap. Major U.S. banks are in the business of taking credit risk and interest rate risk. They therefore do not need counterparties to do dollar swap. The net result is that spread have collapsed and volume has exploded. This means the institutional investor get a better return on their investment and international borrowers pay a lower financing cost. This is turn result in more competitively priced goods for consumer and in enhanced return. Pensioners swap therefore have an effect on almost all of us, yet they remain an arcane derivative risk management tool sometimes suspected of providing the international banking system with tools required to bring about destruction. Although the swap market is now firmly established, there remains a wide divergence among currently and potential users as to how exactly a given swap structure work, what risks are entailed when entering into swap transaction, and precisely What the swap market is, and for that matter, is not the basic swap structures. The growth and continuous success of the swap market has been due small part to the creativity of its participant. As a result, the swap structure currently available and the future potential structures, which will in time become just another market norm, are limited only by the imagination and ingenuity of those participating in the market. Nonetheless, underlying the swap transactions, since in the market today are four basic structures which may now be considered as a fundamental. These structures are the interest rate swap, the fixed rate currency swap, the currency coupon swap, the basis rate swap.